Hello there! In today's tutorial, we will be making a speeding car from a photo of a parked car. We will take this photo and turn it into this. It's a rather long and comprehensive tutorial, so let's get started. First, I go to my collection of road photos in Bridge to find a suitable photo for the composite. I use Bridge for the fast viewability and the integration with Photoshop. When I take my road photos, I also take a photo where there is an actual car driving by, just to be able to scale for the right size of the new car, and to check the direction, size and shape of the shadow. For instance, how this huge shadow looks is hard to predict. By the way, I will soon make a tutorial about how to make perfect shadows. I also take photos with slightly different angles, just to be sure one of my car photos will fit. This one I took with a long exposure time, 1/40 of a second, and here is real motion blur, like what we are gonna recreate artificially later on. It's crucial to have good research material when making composites. Well, these are the landscape photos I will use in today's tutorial. I have collected a lot of red cars and I choose the one suitable for this case. I double click to open them in my RAW converter, select all, and open without adding any adjustments. It's just for finding the right image. This one has to be flipped horizontal. I make a very rough selection with my polygonal lasso tool and add a mask. I have speeded up the process, but I guess you get the idea. Then I go to Bridge and open my landscape with the car passing. Now they are all open in Photoshop, and I go to File, Scripts, Load File into Stack, Add Open Files, and press OK. If we press Alt Option on the eye, this layer will be the only visible. And we can easily find the right car image that fits the perspective of the road without too much tedious masking. I think this image is the best, but we have to remove the sticker, the reflection from the trees, the green cast on the bumper, also these reflections, dirt and other distracting elements. Well, let's open the image once again in the RAW converter. By the way, all the images I took with a 24mm wide angle, so the perspective should be okay. Let's open again, and this time make some adjustments. We only adjust for preserving details, the colors will be adjusted later on. Let's open. Now I use my pen tool to make a precise selection, the best tool for smooth, organic shapes like a car. And again, let's speed up the process a little. We need to use subtract from selection on all the negative spaces. Like that, go to flyout menu and make selection. Feather radius 1 pixel, press OK, and add a mask. Go to layer, new fill layer, solid color. I choose white and OK. This layer is only for checking whether the mask is OK or not. Now let's get rid of the sign, name tag or whatever it is. We do that by selecting and copying the front part here. Command J. Turn off the visibility. Draw around where we have to paste it. And add a mask. Release the chain and transform without transforming the mask. Like that. And a copy of this part. And move it in place. Transform while pressing Alt or Option to distort. A little warping. Add a mask, and this time a hide with a black brush. Now we need to copy this dark reflection. Command J. Move and transform, Command T, and flip horizontal, move, scale, warp, turn off visibility, select the shape. And mask. Let's select all the layers and group, Command G, and name it front. I missed a spot, and I also have to move the car layer out of the group, of course. Now it's time to work with the reflection on the hood. First, let's use our pen tool on the front area. Go to Flyout menu and make a selection. Create a new empty layer with Command Shift N. Let's call it Hood. Add a mask and go to Gradient tool and press Alt or Option to sample a light and a dark color from the hood. And drag out a gradient. Oops. The other way, or shift direction by shifting foreground color to background color with X. Now we can paint in the mask for higher precision. We go fast forward on the rest of the hood. And for cloning out the parking disc. Now it's time to reduce some of the green in the bumper. We add a hue and saturation adjustment layer and press the little hand and sample a color to narrow the adjustment to the yellow-green colors. We can move the slider so we don't affect the orange light, or we can subtract it from the adjustment by using a black brush in the mask. Or even better, start with a black mask and paint with white where we want the effects. I'll dial the opacity down so the adjustment is a little bit more subtle. Let's navigate to our empty road image and open it in the RAW converter. adjust a little and press Shift to open as a smart object. Now we have opened our background as a smart object. That means we can always return to Camera Raw and readjust our image. If we are satisfied with our car, we can group all layers, except the white fill layer, of course. And with the Move tool selected, we can drag and drop our group into the landscape. Now our image size is almost 3 GB. So let's merge the group, Command E, or go to Layer, Merge Group, and we have reduced our image size quite a lot. Only 350 MB now. Now let's convert our car into a smart object. That way we can scale up or down without any loss in resolution. It can sometimes be difficult to find the right size in a composition like this. We still have a long way to go. Let's start by analyzing the shadow. It's actually quite big compared to the size of the car. Let's go back and create a new shadow. Let's move the car a little. And go to Layer, New Fill Layer, Solid Color. Name it Shadow. A blue color. Blend Mode Multiply. Turn the mask to black with Command I. And let's aim for the sun while we are creating the shape of the shadow with Polygonal Lasso Tool. Press Command I again. Deselect Command D. And feather the mask. Let's dial back the opacity a little. We have almost the same color as the shadow here in the back. Let's check the real shadow for a moment. Our shadow are too saturated. Let's dive into the fill color again and desaturate. Like that. And lower the opacity some more. Now it's time for some orange light on the hood. New fill layer, solid color. 255, 128 and 0. Screen blending mode. Clip it to the car layer by pressing Alt or Option between the layers. Double click on the layer to go to Blending Options and go to Blend If. Drag in the underlying layer, black slider, so we only have orange on the lightest areas. Let's divide the slider by pressing Alt or Option for a feathering transition. I always try a few blend modes. Screen is too pale. I go for soft light this time. Maybe a lower opacity is better. And a black mask, Command I. And let's paint with white where we want the effect to be visible. Next thing is a contact shadow. With a lasso tool, we can draw around the two tires and under the car. New fill layer, solid color. Let's name it contact shadow. a blue color, multiply blending mode, and a lot of feather. A little desaturation. The card needs to be darker. A curves adjustment layer. A little down in the shadows. And let's expand the contact shadow with a soft white brush in the mask. Lower the opacity. And desaturate once more. I still think the car needs to be darker. We go to curves. Well, I think a photo filter will do. A blue color. And we don't want to preserve luminosity. Let's invert the mask to black and paint with a white brush in all the areas where the sun don't shine. The wheel, the bumper, a little here and here. And the side of the car. Well, I will fade this last brush stroke. I still need some blue here and there. Now let's create a window. First, polygonal lasso tool. Draw around the areas of the window. A fill layer, a white color, and a low opacity. Maybe a light blue color. And let's find the right opacity for a backlit window. Now let's zoom in. Time for some minor details. Shadow on the trunk. We do that in the photo filter layer. Next thing is some orange haze, an orange fill layer. I know we have a lot of fill layers in this case. Screen blending mode. Invert the mask. Some white brush strokes. And a lot of feather. Let's find the spot where it looks natural, or at least looks atmospherically. Let's make one more copy of the orange layer and fill the mask with black and enhance the orange light just around the sun. I like to keep colors on a natural level, but of course one could go for a more vivid look. The wheel is a little twisted. Let's double click the smart object to dive into the actual car image. Let's select this part of the wheel. Copy to a new layer, Command J, and transform it, Command T, for a better direction. Yes, this looks better. Now we can fix the part that was covered with grass. I start by filling the rounded selection with the color of the tire. Drag the layer underneath the car layer. Then I copy a part of the tire and transform it into place. Warp it a little so it follows the curvation. Mask it with black and paint over the grass with a soft brush and again. Close and save our smart object. Finally, we could go to the tool this case is all about, spin and path blur. Let's make the wheels turn. The ring is the blur area. And the small dots are the feather area. The small inner circle are the amount slider. Let's transform the other wheel. And zoom in for a better visibility. This looks fine, and press OK. The filter comes with a mask, and we can paint out the areas where we don't need blur. Well, we need a bigger area here. Let's drag the circle bigger, like that. And a black brush to unblur this area. I think it looks great. Now let's blur the road. Once again, blur gallery, path blur. And draw arrows for the blur direction. It's very important all the arrows start left and go right. If one goes the other way, the blur will change direction and it looks weird. I drag out arrows so they follow the perspective of the image. One more. A little speed adjustment. And one down here. This looks fine. Press OK. Again, a time-consuming process for my little laptop. I have this driver image, well, I used myself, and I triggered the camera with my smartphone. Let's use the rather new feature, Select Subject, and we are already pretty far in the selection. We only need a little subtracting here and there. It's always in narrow spaces like between the fingers this tool have problems. And a mask. Double click the mask to refine. A little radius. And some refinement in the hair. And we are good to go. We use Move Tool to drag it into our car image. That way we keep our mask that we don't do if we use copy and paste. We convert it into a smart object. I always do that when I'm not certain about the size. Let's scale a little and drag it to the top, well, under the global adjustments. Zoom in. And it's time to make a selection to put the driver behind the windshield. Press Command while clicking on the car layer to reselect the car. Use Polygonal Lasso Tool and Subtract from Selection to make room for the driver behind the steering wheel. Turn on the driver layer, add a mask, and invert the mask, Command-I. Click on the change symbol to release the connection between the mask and the image. And we can now position the image. Now we only need to adjust colors and lightness to finish our composition. With this level adjustment layer, I remove some of the darkest color in the driver. The rest is minor tweaks. Let's turn on the adjustments here. Some shadows on the seats. A yellow fill layer in screen blending mode on the headlights. Orange color in the driver's right side. And maybe a little light on the wooden list. Levels and a black mask paint with white. Refine with black. And I think that's it for today. A speeding car in the sunset. I hope you found this rather long tutorial inspirational. If you did, please like, subscribe, add a comment, or ring that bell for future notifications. Thank you and goodbye.